Hey guys, today I'm going to talk to you about the late bloomer in hockey and the early bloomer. So my son, for example, is a 12-year-old hockey player, which in Canada is a bantam. So on his team, and this goes everywhere, is you've got kids that are physically mature and sometimes a couple years older than their actual age, and we've got kids on our team that are less than 12 years old physically. So there's a challenge. There's a challenge for both, to be honest with you. Right now, at this stage, the late bloomer struggles a little bit more. The early bloomer obviously doesn't because he's physically stronger. Here's the problem with the early bloomer. The early bloomer can get tricked into thinking that he's a really, really good hockey player. But in fact, he could be a good hockey player. But in fact, more often than not, he's physically more mature. So the game comes a little bit easier to him. He's physically stronger. He has a harder shot, can skate faster, he can hit harder. So one of the downfalls of that is that he doesn't necessarily have to work quite as hard to be as good of a hockey player as he possibly can. So the lesson with a early bloomer is understand that if you look around your dressing room and you're more physically mature than some of the guys, that you really have to be cued in and make sure that you're putting in a lot of effort and working your skills harder than anybody else, because honestly, the game could be a little bit easier for you because you just got a little bit more strength. So, and I see that a lot. We just had the Ontario Hockey League draft here in Canada, and what that means is that 16-year-old kids get picked and or drafted, they call it. So what happens is typically most of the kids get drafted or picked early are the kids that are the early bloomers. A lot of the times though is they don't turn out to be the best picks because they've peaked a little bit earlier. So this is where the late bloomers have to really understand this. What I like about the late bloomer, the kids that hit puberty a little bit later, is that they have to struggle and fight for every little thing they have. The game is harder. They have to work harder in practice just to keep up. And if they do have talent, that they have the hard work, then once they hit puberty, once they get physically more mature, they're going to find the game gets a little bit easier. But the great thing about it is that they've got the work ethic to go with it, because they had to fight and scrape away for every little piece that they get. So once they get, I was telling my son this the other day, was when the kids hit when they hit puberty, all of a sudden it's like they're taking steroids, there's a shot of testosterone, and all of a sudden the game starts to become a little bit easier. So my point here is, if you've matured a little bit early, look around, be honest with yourself, and you got to ask yourself the question every day, am I giving it everything I got? Am I working hard? Am I understanding the game? Is my brain locked in? Am I learning? And am I going to stay a step ahead of everybody? And for the little guys, for the late bloomers, just understand that one day it's going to kick in. It might not even be this year. It might take 2 years, 3 years. But these are the guys that I like. These are the guys that understand what it's like to struggle. Because as the game gets harder and the game gets bigger, the guys that have the fight in them are the ones that are going to move on. So young guys, don't get discouraged. Look at your game. Work as hard as you possibly can. Do more than the average guy, because one day it's going to kick in and you're going to have a lot of success. Thank you.